Hello and welcome. My name is Desiree Shaw. I'm a psychotherapist and I vlog and I podcast about mental health. Keen interest in men's mental health, but not solely and not only men's mental health, relationships. Today I'm going to be talking about the covert narcissist, the female psychopath, the dangerous victim. This is quite an interesting story because I've had some very direct encounters with dangerous female psychopathic narcissistic victims, the victimized ones. So let me get a couple of things out before I go ahead with this and everyone thinks, oh my god, she's saying that all women are victims. No, not all women are victims, not at all, and not all victims are narcissists or covert narcissists. So let's look at what a narcissist is. A narcissist is a person who's very manipulative, doesn't think about anybody else's feelings, doesn't take anybody else into consideration. It's all about them, will hurt other people in order to get their needs met, only focus on their needs, okay? Or suck up the oxygen in the room. Literally go, and you won't have any space to breathe. Now, there's two kinds of narcissists. You've got the extroverted narcissist, which comes in and look at me, I'm the best. Look at my trousers, are better than yours. You are rubbish, I am the best. Check me out. Bit like Prince Charming from, you know, Shrek. Whereas the covert, victimized, female victim is a bit like Amy Dune, Jesus Christ. Now she's the mother of all victimized, narcissistic, scary females, and the horrible part about her, which is so true as well, everybody loved her as well, she played the victim really well. So playing the victim, so covert female dangerous victims play the victim. Woe is me. If you notice with Amy, there's that scene where she kills the guy and she's wearing his blood, and like any normal person would want to wash it off. She wants you to see it. Look at my pain. Yeah. So a covert female victimized narcissist, they're the kind of person that would trip and scrape their leg, but they will then make out that they tripped, broke their leg, and now need a hip replacement. You'll be hearing that they're going for surgery, and you'll be thinking, I swear you just scraped your leg. But then everybody else thinks it's actually a hip replacement. And it's not! Anyway, because they are covert and narcissistic, and they're a victim, they need the attention because their needs were not met as a child. Now, Amy, her needs were not met because when she was young, she was, her parents had written a book, Amazing Amy, who was great at everything. She was Amazing Amy and she couldn't live up to it. So what happened was she'd been victimized at some point by men at one point, then she just ran with it. And now she decided that they were all gonna pay. And that's what happens when you become a covert narcissist, dangerous victim. You decide that you're going to get your needs met, and anybody that appears to be like the person who hurt you in the beginning is going to doubly pay. They can even just bear resemblance, have some kind of tendencies, be a threat in some kind of way. Yeah. As a woman, we are put up against each other quite easily and very much all the time. So often females against female narcissist covert.
I don't care. I want an ice cream.
Now, Janie, I told you.
I want it. I make the money so I can have what I want.
Now, Janie, that's enough.
Leave me alone. I need an ice cream.
Child of mine.
Well, if you need an ice cream, I guess you better have some. I mean, it's pretty hot and all. But remember, this is the last time this week.
All right, Daddy. Blanche wants some too. We gotta have some ice cream for Blanche.
I don't want anything.
What do you think you're trying to do?
I always say it's the parents' fault in cases like this.
I'm really the fool.
Sure is a hot day today.
You're the lucky one, Blanche. Really, you are. Someday it's going to be you that's getting all the attention. And when that happens, I want you to try to be kinder to Jane and your father than they are to you now. Do you know what I mean? Uh-huh. I hope you'll try and remember that.
I won't forget. You bet I won't forget.
Victims are probably really, really dangerous. But what does happen as well is men get it. They're not exempt. Men can become covert narcissists as well, and victims. But because as being a woman, it's more fitting that we're victims. So it's easily played by a woman.
You've got me. Who's got you? I can't.
Yeah, it's easily played. Not that it is played by only by a woman. It's easily played, which is why, and it's abused. So this, the whole Me Too campaign, where there's a lot of people talking about things that have affected them due to sexual trauma, has also been abused by those who haven't had that happen, but because of their sexual, you know, stature as being female, it's acceptable to accept that. And some people are now using that, and they really shouldn't be. But so a covert female narcissist is all about manipulation, all about control, and their need is to control relationships, sabotage relationships as well. So if they feel that they're not getting the love and the attention that they deserve, or somebody else is getting it or getting more of it, they will seek to ruin that relationship in order to gain the relationship for themselves, because they are narcissists. Narcissists are self-indulged. They have got this way because they never got their needs met, and that is the worry. So when we look at Amy, how scary she is, she's like the baddest of them all. She's very much all focused about her, and it's really dangerous because she causes death and prison sentences. So they create a victim like tendencies. They have victim tendencies, and they often say things like this. Listen to the language of a covert narcissist. A covert victimized, a dangerous victim, will say things like, it's not fair. That, you know, they always, things are never ever fair. It's not fair. I should have that as well. What about me? It's always like that, you know. A covert female narcissist, your victim, could be out and could be at somebody else's birthday party, for example. It's not even their birthday party, and watching somebody else getting all the attention and become so enraged inside themselves because somebody else is getting all the attention, they might say something like, they didn't do this for my birthday. They actually hold their face like that as well. I've seen it. They will become quite focused on what they haven't got, and will then start spreading little seeds, little droplets, crumbs, like Hansel and Gretel, little seeds to feed to other people and how terrible life has been for them. So they don't really say it out loud. They don't say it so bad, like, oh, those people treat me really bad. What they will say is, they never did that for me. Well, all I'm saying is, I wasn't treated the same. They're very childish as well. And before you know it, they'll create a circle of friendships or people that they know, and they will paint such a violently ugly depiction of another group of people. Yeah? And they will do this openly, without shame, and not take responsibility for their actions. Yeah? And they will lie. And as their lies come out and their mouths become twisted and caught up with their lies, they still won't take ownership. It will still be somebody else's fault. So working with a covert female narcissist is the most dangerous thing you could ever do. I wouldn't do it. Also, as well, being in a situation where they're out to get you.
Now, the whole damn world comes running, don't you? Lunch, Miss Hudson.
We do have low level, not the high level of Amy. We have lower level, because Amy is the baddest us of them all. She's a psychopath who wins. Not all female victimized narcissists win. They may win for a short time, but they're so encompassed about themselves and so selfish, they will ruin whatever they've won at one stage or another. Yeah, very soon. They always have a set of dramas that follow them. They're like a domino effect. They make bad decision after bad decision. They cause a lot of upheaval. And they're always, 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 always the victim. Yeah, and it's recognizing that, okay? Manipulation is the key. Their behavior, the way they set things up. They set things up in a way which is so dangerous for anybody that gets in their way. Anybody that they see a threat. They want to paint you as a bad picture. So guess what? If you've walked into the room and you've handed them a glass of water, okay, because they asked you for it. Everybody else in the room thinks that you're giving them this as punishment. And when they take the water from you and their backs to everybody else, they might smile at you. Then they turn to everybody else and they might give a face. Don't know why she gave me this. Always treats me like this. I wanted orange juice and look, she's giving me water. They'll do that. They would have said to you, get me some water. But everybody else would have thought that you got them the water because you don't want to share the drink that you got in your fridge. That's how dangerous they are, yeah? They will blatantly create lies upon lies against you, and they will have a really great setup to do it. So they will even have an argument with you and then tell you that they're ready to forgive you. When they do that, they want you to accept that you're the person in the wrong, even though they created the drama in the first place. Very manipulative, very dangerous. And the way to deal with them, run! Run! Run, Forrest, run! And hide and cover yourself. You're not going to get very far with them because they're not going to take any responsibility whatsoever. The worst kind of female covert narcissists are the ones which a lot of men are having to deal with not seeing their kids. Not all women who are single mums stop the fathers from seeing their kids. That's not what I'm saying here, okay? And not all fathers are bad to their single, to their woman they've broken up with. But there are some women out there who are victimized, dangerous narcissists who put themselves in a position to be seen as...
Show them how you ain't got no car seats in the car.
I got car seats in my car.
Well, show the car seats in. Where your car seats? Where your car seats?
This is my personal property, man.
That's why I can't come back over, because y'all act like y'all don't know respect and boundaries. It's respect and boundaries. I asked y'all not, you nor your girlfriend, wife, whatever the fuck she is, not to put
my fiance
in my kid's head. Period. It's a wrap. Do whatever you want to do.
The victim, therefore, sometimes getting themselves pregnant on purpose so that guy has to remain in their lives forever, even if that was not the intention, and not that anybody can purposely make themselves pregnant. But we know there are other things. But hey, everybody is responsible. We're all responsible for ourselves, so recognize that. But what can happen is that when they tend to have children to gain attention as well, and they sometimes have lots of children for different people, because they're bad at relationships. Relationships are just the worst thing for a covert dangerous victim, because they can't connect. They're so stuck. Their self-esteem is normally shot down to the ground. Their confidence is shot. They have no direction for the future. I mean, they're not all like Amy. Not like Amy did. Is it Amy Dune? Amy Dunn? Amy did? Amy did it, didn't she? But they're not all like that. Often they are... They're not that clever. But they're dangerous and they can cause a lot of harm. And they sabotage relationships. And they will ruin your name. So, if you are dealing with... Or have any, if you have a work colleague who is a dangerous, victimized, narcissist, covert female, I've said it all backwards, haven't I? If it's your partner, God rest your soul. If it's a family member, you don't always have to be around them. If it's your neighbor, keep it wide. Your best bet is to have minimal contact. Yeah, that's the safest thing you can do. But remember this, they will tell people bad things about you, whether you have a overloaded contact, minimal contact, or no contact. You will always be the bad guy. That's because they're a female covert, victimized, dangerous narcissist, and that's what they do. So Thank you for watching this video. My name is Desiree Shaw. Please subscribe, like and subscribe, like and subscribe, and comment. Tell me what you think. You know, maybe it's a bit too controversial for you and you don't like it. Maybe I'm saying some things and you really want me to stop, and you think I'm not, or I know, maybe you know someone. Do you know somebody like this? You're somebody that's this manipulative and does things in a way, and no matter what you say, they will spin it in a different format and tell the world a different story. And you'll come out trying to explain yourself. Never, you know what? I'll leave you with this. Never explain yourself when it comes to a covert female, dangerous, victimized narcissist. Don't even waste your time. Waste of time. Don't explain yourself. I'm telling you. Actually agree with them and say, yeah, okay, thanks. But no thanks. I mean, bye for now. My name's Desiree Shaw.
I didn't mean her any harm.
Better not have done her any harm.
My God, Miss Blackett, what has she done to you?
Get her off in a minute, Miss Blackett. Don't worry, Miss Blackett. I'll get you down from here. I know, Miss Blackett, I know. Just rest easy.
Also, a really good crime scene analysis would have revealed a little bit of a problem with her story. If she was tied up all the time, how'd she get the box cutter? And how'd she get it under the pillow? A good detective would have seen way too many contradictions in her story and not the forensic evidence to back it up. She would have been brought in for more questioning, and there would have been questions she could not answer.
Tanya Head was just one of 19 people who had been above the point of impact in the South Tower, lived to tell about it. After being badly burned, Tanya witnessed the decapitation of her assistant before coming across a dying man who begged her to deliver his wedding ring to his wife. Her own survival, she said, was made possible by the thoughts of beautiful white dress she would be wearing for her fiancé Dave on their wedding day. Soon after, this woman would learn that Dave, who had been working in the North Tower, didn't make it. Despite that devastating loss, Tanya became a beacon of hope. She lobbied to have survivors invited to annual 9/11 commemorations, have them represented in the 9/11 Museum, even gave Rudy Giuliani, Michael Bloomberg, a tour of Ground Zero. But Tanya, you see, had a very dark secret. She wasn't even in the United States on September 11th. It was all a lie. Robin Fisher and Angelo Guglielmo Jr. wrote about Tanya's extraordinary deception. Their new book is entitled The Woman Who Wasn't There.